Greetings and welcome back to NYSORA's YouTube channel. As a practicing anesthesiologist, I have performed countless IV cannulations and I have taught students, nurses, younger colleagues, anesthesiologists, name it. And in this video, we're going to feature what I think are the three most common reasons why IV fail. By watching this video, I'm sure you'll pick up quite a few additional tips and tricks on how to become a lot better at intravenous cannulation. So let's get started. So what we have here is the catheter over the needle system, or an IV. We have a sample of the tissue with a peripheral vein underneath the dermis, settled in the subcutaneous tissue. Typically, you would like to place your needle with the catheter into the vein, and once inside the vein, you want to advance the needle catheter system a little bit deeper, but the only way to make that advancement is to lower the angle of the needle catheter insertion so you can place that needle catheter system deeper, and then you simply take the needle out, leaving the IV catheter inside the lumen of the vein. Now notice how here we have this chamber, and this chamber is where the blood will first appear. So we use in this chamber to monitor when the needle tip enters inside the vein. That would be an indication that it's time to lower the angle, advance the needle catheter system deeper, and take the needle out to leave the catheter inside the vein. So here's the mistake number one. In this particular example, the catheter needle system is simply too short for the depth of the vein. In other words, once you advance the catheter and the needle and place it inside the vein, there'll be very little of the catheter, too short, left inside the vein to make it stable. And as soon as the tissue moves or a patient bends the hand or anything like this, there's a little tag on the IV, the catheter tends to fall outside of the vein into the subcutaneous tissue. So here's the catheter passing through the dermis and edging towards the vein. As soon as the catheter enters the vein, we will immediately see the flashback, as we call it, because the blood will want to go into the expansion chamber. And there it is. So now we know that we're inside the vein. And at this point in time, what we simply do is continue advancing the catheter, lower the angle, and pull the needle out, leaving the catheter inside. But again, if you can take a look at this image, you can see how very little of the catheter is inside the vein to make it stable. So as soon as there is any tag or traction force or patient bending the arm, there's a really good chance that this catheter will fall outside the vein and result in a paravenous or subcutaneous infusion of the IV solution. To prevent this from happening, the catheter simply has to be much longer, perhaps by 1 or 2 centimeters longer. So once you place it inside the vein, you have enough leeway, enough slack, so it does not fall outside of the vein. Tip number two. In this case, we have a catheter needle system that is just about to pierce the skin. Let's watch this. As the catheter needle system goes through the skin and the dermis, and it's approaching the vein now, you can see the needle opening is now inside the vein, and we immediately see the flashback in the monitoring chamber. This really means that the opening of the needle is now intravascular inside the vein, but it does not necessarily mean that the catheter is also inside the vein. So in this case, we should decrease the angle of the needle and advance the catheter needle system further. But in this example, this doesn't happen. The operator is happy with the fact that this is already inside the vessel, and attempt to feed the catheter will result in a catheter placement inside the subcutaneous tissue, but not intravenously. So that is one of the most common mistakes that you see all the time. And that is, as soon as the flashback appears, the operator is happy with the position and tries to feed the catheter over the needle, whereas in fact, you should advance it deeper inside the vein to make sure that there is enough slack and that the catheter is inside the vein as well. Mistake number three. In this situation, we can see the needle catheter system that is aiming towards the peripheral vein, but here you can see how this angle of insertion is rather large. When you have an angle insertion that is so large, it is really difficult to atone for it eventually when the needle enters the vein. It simply is too tenuous. You really need to enter this at a much lower angle to have more slack to be able to readjust the needle angle one more time and feed the needle catheter system deeper. Let's see the problem. Failure to advance the needle at a low angle often results in a needle passage through the vein completely, and again, catheter placement paravenously into the subcutaneous tissue. So that's the needle catheter system. It passes through the skin. Now it is in the vein, and as soon as it is in the vein, we can see the flashback. So the operator thinks, okay, we're there, and now what we need to do is we need to advance the needle catheter system a little bit deeper so it is inside the vein. Unfortunately, this high angle will prevent the operator from advancing it at the angle at which the catheter and the needle will stay inside the vein. The needle catheter passes through the vein, and an attempt to feed the catheter clearly will result in a catheter placement paravenously. And these are the three most common reasons why IV catheters fail. The catheter is too short, reason number one. Number two, the catheter needle system was not placed long enough inside the lumen of the vein to allow for enough slack so that the catheter does not migrate into the subcutaneous space. Reason number three, the angle of catheter needle system insertion is way too steep, and the operator does not have a chance to recorrect it and advance it sufficiently long inside the lumen of the vein. Thank you for watching.